Having explored NDVI using different scripts and datasets, we are now going to export this data into QGIS and display it there so that we can combine it with our other data. Open the final version of the NDVI script. There is a link in the video description. Scroll down to line 57. This is the only new part of the script. It exports the Sentinel-2 and Landsat-5 NDVI data to Google Drive. You should now be familiar with this from previous tutorials. Change the processing area to your area of interest. Make sure that you are happy with the dates selected for the two collections. And then run the script. Make sure you're happy with the result. And then click on the Tasks tab in the console window. Click the Run button next to NDVI Landsat 5. Everything here can stay the same, except it's a good idea for the file name to add your general area and the date that you're interested in. Then click Run. Repeat this for the Sentinel-2 NDVI data. If you want to export more than one Sentinel-2 or Landsat-5 NDVI dataset, then change the dates in the code and rerun the script, and then repeat the export process. You can start the second batch before the first batch completes. When the export process is completed, hover your mouse over the tasks and click the question mark button, and then select Open in Drive. You will then see your images inside your Google Drive folder. Right-click them to download. Save them in your Google Earth Engine folder, or download them and then move them to this folder from your Downloads folder. Switch to QGIS and add these rasters to your project. You will see that they are displayed in black and white. We want to use the same colors we used in Google Earth Engine. For this, you will need to download the NDVI Color Map QGIS text file from the IAMINA training website and save it in your NDVI folder. Then in QGIS, right-click the first NDVI raster and select Properties. Select the Symbology tab and then change Render Type from Single Band Gray to Single Band Pseudo Color. Underneath the different colors, click the Load Color Map button. Find your NDVI Color Map QGIS text file and click Open. And then, if you browse through the colors, you can see it uses the same color scheme as Google Earth Engine. Then click Apply and OK. We then need to repeat this for the other NDVI raster, but we can do this by right-clicking it, selecting Styles, Copy Style, and then right-clicking it and selecting Paste Style, and you'll see they now use the same symbology. You can now use this to make a map in QGIS showing agricultural areas in your study area. Feel free to add any other relevant data, such as your sites. If you want to keep your script for future reference, don't forget to click the arrow next to save and save as, and then it will be saved in your scripts window. For this tutorial, we want you to create multiple maps in QGIS using NDVI data from Google Earth Engine, showing changes in agricultural practices or vegetation cover over time in your area of interest.